Does installing lots of programs really mess up your PC? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Question I got. I try to limit the number of programs I install on my system. I do this because I feel intuitively that the more programs I install, the more quickly Windows reaches that corrupted state that we all know too well and has to be reinstalled from scratch. I really could make good use of quite a number of programs I don't have installed, but I worry about hastening corruption. I do assume that I can load as many portable applications as I like without worry. Am I on the right track, or is my thinking just incorrect? In theory, installing lots of different programs shouldn't destabilize the system, regardless of how they're installed. Reality says otherwise. The real answer is it really depends more on the specific software than on how you install it. What you're talking about has a name. It's called software rot. It refers to the gradual decrease in quality and performance of software and thus of your system over time. Today's systems and software are so complex. Installing software, even if it is just the first run of a portable application, the kind that requires no setup program, is also complex. Subsequent updates and uninstalls all add to the complexity. As a result, it's easy for settings, both the settings you see and the thousands of internal settings used only by the applications in Windows, to get confused. Depending on the software you're running, that confusion can do nothing, or it can cause the software or even Windows itself to misbehave. Now, the most common culprit I see in generating software rot is installing and uninstalling a lot of software that you just want to try out. Now, I get it. It's important to evaluate software to see if it meets your needs. To do so, you typically need to install it and run it. And then, of course, if you decide it's not what you need, you uninstall it. If you do this often, it's a bigger cause of system destabilization or software rot than simply installing and keeping the software you use regularly up to date. The good news is that things have actually improved dramatically in recent years. I can imagine I frequently install and uninstall software and rarely suffer because of it. So don't stop trying things out. Your machine should meet your needs. I do have one recommendation, though, and you'll probably see this one coming. Back up. Before you install something you're just trying out, back up your system completely. Ideally, you're already doing this by virtue of having a daily backup solution in place. But that way, if something does go wrong with the trial or its uninstall, or if it includes pups and malware or worse, you can quickly and easily revert to the state of your machine prior to the installation. Besides, things can go wrong for reasons unrelated to software installations, trials, or software rot. Backups, of course, protect you from all. Now, I do want to talk a little bit about portable apps. A portable app, by definition, is an app that requires no setup or installation process. You copy it to your machine and you start using it. To uninstall it, you delete the files or folders you copied. In theory, portable apps often do install or configure things the first time you run them. In a sense, there's still a setup process, you just don't see it. Now, portable apps tend to do little in the way of setups, but there are no guarantees. That's why I fall back to being more concerned about what software you're installing and not how much or whether it's portable or not. Unfortunately, it's nearly impossible to determine how an application will behave prior to installing it. But if your portable, no install needed app includes a link or instructions to uninstall, then chances are it has done something in the way of an installation. So, yeah, within reason, install and evaluate what you need and use. Use your computer the way you need to. That's the point. Don't spend a lot of time worrying about software rot. Spend that energy on staying safe instead. Honestly, these days, that's probably the greater risk. Just make sure you're backing up along the way. That'll protect you from much, much more than just software rot. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/6406. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.